I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me to be. I don't have a body problem, I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. The body problem doesn't exist, therefore it has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Welcome to the video. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. It is time to bring the hammer down. The world is so messed up. Time to bring the hammer down. How do we bring the hammer down? No body, no world, no problem. No body, no world, no problem. You see, we have simply been playing along with the false notion that there is a world, and to honor time, because there's so many aspects of spirit, the one spirit, that are honoring time by pretending there's a world and their bodies, and therefore there's actually a way to train to be greater than God. The truth is, there is no world. The truth is, there are no bodies. There are no needs. There, no body, no needs, no world, no problem. No body, no needs, no world, no problem. No body, no needs, no world, no problem. This is bringing the hammer down. It's time to bring the hammer down, meaning enough's enough, enough's enough. We're no longer going along with the charade that there's a world. But we're so used to doing this that it may take a little bit of, we may feel a little bit of consternation as we shift back to the truth of the matter. There's actually no body either. No body, no needs, no world, no problem. No body, no needs, no world, no universe, no things, no problem. The inherent nature of all is emptiness, meaning empty, empty of all thingness. Empty of all thingness. That's what emptiness means. It doesn't mean it's a vacuum or an abyss. It's empty of thing nature, of essential nature in terms of thing, form, specification. There's nothing that is specified in reality. All is free. All is free, all is free, all is free. Each moment is completely open to all potential. Every single moment is entirely open to all potential. Therefore, there is no world. There is absolutely no such thing as any world. There's no such thing as a body, too. So this is really bringing the hammer down just in time, because, you know, enough's enough with this world. Enough is enough. I've just had it with this world, with the belief there's a world, with the belief that there are bodies, with the belief that there are needs. All this is absolute nonsense. Again, we just played along, humoring the madness of our brothers in spirit, the madness of that, to honor time, not to disagree. But we're now saying for sure, there is no body, there are no needs, no bodies, no needs, no worlds, no problem whatsoever. Because in this moment, each moment, we are perfectly free to be, to experience, for experiencing this moment, moment by moment, experiencing whatever it is that we want to be and experience. There is no time. There is no time at all. Time is the idea that moments are bound one to another. In process, there is no time. No bodies, no needs, no time, no world, no bodies, no needs, no world, no time, no problem. No bodies, no need, no world, no time, no problem. There is no abyss, no bodies, no need, no world, no time, no abyss, no problem. There's only the complete fullness of omnipotential, omnipresence of omnipotential. Always and always and always. Just let this sink in. At some point you'll realize there isn't any world. There's no past. There's no future. There's no past. There's no future. There's no time. No past, no future, no time, no problem. No past, no future, no time, no problem. No past, no future, no time, no problem. And just have the courage to say this. As you say it, you start breaking the ice bit by bit by bit until the point comes when we're able to say, yeah, no problem, absolutely no problem. Past, no future, no time, no problem. Now we might as well do this now because tomorrow, you know, then it's going to be too late very soon. The future does not look too bright here, does it? It does not. And where's here? Well, this training program that we're trying to train ourselves. I've gone over and over that, but bottom line is, it doesn't look very bright. It doesn't look very promising. There's no need to continue on with the charade that I am a body. I am not a body. No one is a body. There are no bodies, actually. What we call a body, you see, whatever we call form, we think has continuity in time and space. It has no continuity. Nothing has continuity. It's merely a collective agreement that we have made here to act in our imaginings as if everything did have continuity, but it doesn't really have continuity. I would hope that the next step we can take is to see the living light, the form of everything in the form of living light instead of this dead light form that we're looking at now. That would be the next step into realizing that, hey, everything really is. You could see, like, wow, how it could easily shift into something else immediately. Any plant, anything can simply shift, and eventually we could see everything is just this potential flow. All can meld into, morph. Everything can morph into, anything can morph into anything, is a way of putting it. Any appearance at any moment can morph into anything else. Okay, get that. Any appearance there is at any moment can instantly morph into anything else. Period. But the solidity that we see, like, with our body's the sensory perception, solidity, we think, oh, that's impossible. If we were to see everything in its light form, in its light body form, then we would say, hey, sure, it's possible. Sure, it's possible. Now, what we're getting at here is what has to be gotten to, and we might as well try to get to it because the times are unacceptable now. It's time has become the notion of time has become unacceptable. The notion of bodies has become unacceptable. The notion of a world has become unacceptable. These are unacceptable notions now, contrivances. They're unacceptable. You can no longer continue this charade that their bodies and needs and worlds and things and all of this. It's a charade. It's a very bad charade, and we just cannot continue with that. So we might as well go for it. That's what I'm doing here, just going for it. And you will see that in going for it, you succeed. You succeed in no longer going along with the charade. It's just a charade we're going along with, to tell you the truth. It is just a charade. We've agreed, okay, I'll go along with the charade because, you know, to honor time for everybody else. But, you know, the way that they're using their moments, the way they're using the situation is so terrible. We have to say enough is enough. We're no longer going to go along with the charade. That's enough. We never said we'd go along with it forever. All right? And if we did, we were mistaken. And we have to correct that mistake. So this is enough. It's enough is enough. So it's hammer time. Absolutely hammer time. Put the hammer down. And it's time that we no longer go along with this whole charade of fear, bodies, vulnerability, fear, location thing. If anything can morph into anything at any moment, where is location? What does location have to do with anything? Where is here? Under those circumstances, where is here? Where is the location? Where's the center of it then? If absolutely anything can morph into anything else at any moment, where's the center? Where is the center of all this? Where are things located? Where are appearances located? Is it right to speak of definitions and locations? If this plant here can morph into anything else, any instant can morph into anything else you could possibly imagine, what is the definition of this? What is the definition? What is the definition of anything? What is the definition of this plant? Is it a plant? Or is it everything, actually? Potentially anything and everything at any moment. And if everything is that way, where are the definitions? Where are the definitions of... are there any definitions? Are there any valid definitions? All right, bringing the hammer down on this. It's time. Quote unquote, time. It's the foolishness is just reaching epic proportions in the world. That's enough. So if anything can morph into anything else at any instant, any and all instants, forever and forever and forever, where are the definitions? Where are the things? Where are the worlds? Where are the bodies? There's just experiencing, just no experiencer, but just experiencing. Now we've agreed here, some sort of agreement, or at least we at least pretend to go along with this realm where it seems like the light is frozen and morphing doesn't happen. And again, if anything can morph into anything at any moment, where are the genetics? Where is the DNA? You know, where's all the form characteristics? What is that? It's all meaningless, isn't it? Meaningless. This realm is the realm of what we call reproduction. It is genetics and DNA and things, and we think we can reproduce stuff, which is, you know, utterly bizarre compared, you know, to reality. There's no reproduction of reality whatsoever. Again, everything is everything. Everything is always everything. Everything is everything always. Everything is everything. All is all always. All is all always. Bring the hammer down like that. All is all always. All is all always. So where's the definition? Where's definition? Where's valuing? Where's definition? Where's valuing? Where's knowledge, so to speak? Where's knowledge? Where's intellect? just let it all sink in. All is all, always. All is all, always. If anything and everything can instantly morph into anything and everything whatsoever. All is all, always, right? All is all, always. All is all, always. God is everywhere. God is everywhere. The allness, all is always, always, is everywhere. And our seeing it otherwise is a pretension, it's a pretense, it's a hallucination. It's not really true. I used to run these morphing programs, I loved them. Because it gave you a better sense of what reality is like. It's everything, and everything, you know, can morph into anything, always. So it's all about landing the heavy blows right now of truth and just see where that brings you. That's what it's all about right now. Nobody, no needs, no world, no problem, no problem at all. Because anything, all is all, anything is everything, and everything is anything. How can there be needs? The infinite plasticity of the living light. It's all just a living light giving the experience. It never, whatever appearance arises, it's all always the living light, always abiding in pure spaciousness. And it can appear as anything else you want. So how can you have needs? Whatever it is you want to experience instantly, that's what you're experiencing. There's no gap, so how can there be a need? How can we say there be a need? And the body is a symbol of needs. The body is a symbol of needs. We say the body has needs. No, we're just imagining needs, projecting them onto the body and saying the body has the needs. Really, we don't have a body. There's no body. There's no world. And we certainly don't need intelligence about any things, do we? Like we say, okay, I know what this thing is, I know this thing, I know. Because there are no things, there are no things. If any appearance can instantly morph into any other appearance whatsoever, or non-appearance whatsoever, how can you say there are things? Actual things. And so what can you say? You know things. Say, I don't know anything. I do not know anything. This is, again, bringing the hammer down. I don't know anything. I do not know anything whatsoever. I do not know anything whatsoever. A powerful statement. I do not know anything whatsoever. I do not know anything. It's absolutely true. There are no things to know. Even though this world gives a very convincing illusion that there is, don't believe it. We fashion this to deceive ourselves, so we have to use the will. There are no things whatsoever. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. That's the greatest statement. I don't know anything. I do not know anything whatsoever, because there's nothing to know. There are no things to know. This is actually awakening to spirit. Spirit says, oh, I'm starting to remember now. There is nothing to know. There is nothing to know. There is nothing to know. There are no things to know. So we don't need knowledge of things. That's what blocks awareness of reality from us. Knowledge of things. I do not know anything. This is a declaration, a very positive declaration of spirit waking up. Because spirit will first thing will say, oh yeah, there are no things. So how can I know anything? I do not know anything. I don't know. I do not know anything. I cannot know anything. There are no things. I don't know anything. I can never know anything. There are no things. There are no things. Declare this. I don't know anything. I can never know anything. There are no things. Or, I don't know anything. There are no things. Therefore, I can never know anything. I can never know anything. There are. I don't know anything. There are no things. I can never know anything. I can never know anything. I can never know anything. And so that's a very, very positive statement. It vivifies the spirit. It wakes it up. It's smelling salts. What we're doing is giving smelling salts for spirit here. I don't know anything. I can't know anything. I can never know anything. There isn't anything to know. Nothing exists. There is nothing. No things exist. No things exist. There are no things. There are no things. There are no things I can know, nothing that I can know. There's nothing that I can ever know. There's no thing that I can ever know. So I don't know anything. It's a statement of awakening. I don't know anything. This is the condition of awakening. I don't know anything. Very contrary to what the world tells us, right? The ego. We say, hey, I don't know anything. That is the best thing to say. I don't know anything. Therefore, I don't know any past. I don't know any future, do I? Isn't the our belief in the past and future based on our presumed knowledge of things? But there are no things. And I don't know anything. I will never know anything. There's nothing to know. Therefore, things have no value. So then how can there be a past or a future? I just had an experience right now of not being able to project into the future at all. I couldn't think into the future. That's great. That's great. This is what we're doing. We're time crunching. We're crunching time. The whole notion of time needs to be crunched. Spirit wake up. Spirit thinks it's supposed to be able to identify things and says, how am I going to do that? And so the sleep of spirit is really this is not so much a sleep as it is a laying low and saying, I don't think I can do this. I'm not yet viable in the new way, which is to know things. So spirit is trying to find a new way of being. And it feels so, how will you say, so meek and incapable of learning this new way. And so it feels like it's like incompetent. So incompetent it doesn't want to show its face. Spirit feels this way, so incompetent, so incapable, doesn't want to show its face. It says, how can I know things, Spirit says. So it pretends that it doesn't even exist. It's embarrassed. It doesn't want to be known that it exists. Because it feels like if I know that I exist, then I'll be exposed how incompetent I am, and that I can't figure out how to know things. I'm unable to know things. Well, the answer to that is there are no things. Spirit is not incompetent. I am not incompetent. There are no things to know. There are no things to know. So we're not incompetent. We need to keep reminding Spirit of this fact, because it tends to feel very inferior over its inability to locate anything. And ego is pretending to be so superior to Spirit. Ego says, I know where everything is. I can locate anything. He says, I know all sorts of knowledge about things. Ask about anything. I can tell you about things. The Spirit says, well, I don't know anything. What is this world that ego is seeing? Well, it's seeing a hallucination. Ego seeing a hallucination, a fantasy. It doesn't exist. Spirit's the one that's seeing truly. There are no things. But we only listen to the ego. The ego will say, hey, I've done the impossible. I've made things. So you need to do it. Ego tells us we need to get used to things, get acquainted with things. So we're trying. Spirit says, okay, I'm trying. I'm just failing. Wow, what if Spirit is so demoralized by all this failure to know things, to understand things, to find things. To Spirit, everything is just all one. Picture of the living light is presented to us, only just one picture. I'm normal. I'm okay. This is reality. There isn't anything. There's never been anything. Nothing's ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. This is another statement we can make. Nothing has ever happened. There are no things. Nothing has ever happened. No thing has ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. That is so true. So we're affirming Spirit. What we're doing, affirming Spirit, saying, you know, wake up, get up, Spirit. You're lying on the ground like you're dead. You're so demoralized. You say, I don't even want to get up. Get up, Spirit. Wake up. Get up. Come on, get up. Nothing has ever happened. Yes, nothing has ever happened. That is absolutely true. Nothing has ever happened. Absolutely true. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. Okay, that's enough for right now, and I'll see if I can do some more of this time crunching a little bit later. Okay, very great, that's it.